It's baseball time in Sheboygan. Good evening, A's fans. I'm Jared Ertman here at Wildwood Baseball Park to bring you exciting Sheboygan A's baseball action. Tonight, the A's take on the Green Bay Storm in a Northeastern Wisconsin League game, and it is an overcast, drizzly night here at Wildwood Park. It's been raining for about the last hour and a half. A nice drizzle. The game scheduled to go off on time here. They are now bringing the tarp rollers out to the mound and the plate to roll it off so we can get going. So, no rain delay as of yet. And again, the A's taking on the Green Bay Storm. A's are coming off a win just yesterday up at Manitowoc versus the Bandits. That was a 14-1 victory, but it followed a loss on Tuesday, 11-6, at Oshkosh versus the Giants, which broke a four-game winning streak that the A's had going over the weekend in the Wisconsin State League Challenge. Overall, coming into today, the A's are 23-13. 9-4 in the Northeastern Wisconsin League. That is good for third place in the Wisconsin, in the rather Northeastern Wisconsin Baseball League standings, tied with the Appleton Legends. Both with 9 wins, 4 losses, the Menasha Max lead the league. They are 10-4. They played one more game, so it all pretty close up there at the top of the Northeastern Wisconsin League. In Northeastern Wisconsin League play, the A's have scored 91 runs, allowed 55. They are 6-0 at home in the new and 3-4 on the road, and that's kind of been the story of the A's season and has been for a couple of years now. Disparity between the home and away records. Is doing very well, having a great home field advantage here at Wildwood Park, but even against mediocre teams, being in danger on the road. Last season, the A's kind of overcame that. They had a very, very deep team. This year, also a team with a lot of talent, but those problems on the road resurfacing. A's baseball is brought to you by Bud Light, the perfect beer for whatever happens, and also Larry's Distributing, distributors of Budweiser products, Sargento, Legend Larry's, Trilling True Value Hardware, DeFore Advertising, Culver's, Miesfeld's, makers of quality meats since 1941, Q-Mart, Northwood Superior Chemical Co., Aurora Sports Medicine. Aurora provides the athletic trainers that keep the A's healthy and in the game. Papa Murphy's Pizza, Superior Lawn and Garden Center, BioLife Plasma Services, Faze Pizza, The Breeze, 1420 AM Radio, Wisconsin Bank and Trust, Art Imigs, Bank First National, Memorial Mall, and Wigwam. We thank these and the many other sponsors of A's baseball that keep the A's a fine organization on and off the field. The umpires and the opposing managers meeting at the plate now to exchange lineups and discuss things before the game begins. A lineup for the visiting Green Bay Storm, Mitch Egan will lead off. He'll be playing left field. Tyler Brown, the center fielder, will bat second, followed by the shortstop, Adam Anguia, and Cody Schaefer, the second baseman, will bat cleanup. Be followed by Kyle Mrozinski, the third baseman, Cole Hansen, the first baseman, Bob Lemieux will be behind the plate, Brett Knorr on the mound for the Green Bay Storm, and he'll be batting eighth. Rounding out the lineup for the Storm, Kito Kasberg, and he'll be in right. And here is the starting lineup for your Sheboygan A's. Mark Wallace will get the call to start on the mound tonight. And behind him in the field will be Dan Barwick in center, Blake Fleischman at second, Wyatt Olson in right, Harry Stelt at third. Taylor Grimm will be designated hitting tonight. Adam Ryan will be playing first. Carter Amundson will be the shortstop. Hayden Fenner will be the catcher, and Cole McLavick will be in left tonight. Your Sheboygan A's are, of course, managed by Derek Lumen. And the teams have taken their positions, and in moments we'll have the national anthem here at Wildwood Park. Skipper of the Green Bay Storm is Wilmette. Now Wallace taking his warm-up pitches here. Wallace, a right-handed pitcher with a big delivery. despite the rain, game set to go off right at time. We are at 7:30, and stepping in to lead off the game is Mitch Egan. First pitch from Wallace, swung on, sent into shallow left. It will be caught by center fielder Barwick, and that's one away. One pitch, one out. How's that for efficiency? Now here's Tyler Brown. Strike one called. And strike, or rather a ball, that one just missed. Swing and a little looper that will be bobbled and dropped. Not really bobbled, it was misjudged by Adam Ryan. He thought he had it. Bounced under his glove, couldn't make the shoelace catch, and Brown ends up on first. Calling it a single. Or runner aboard first, and here's Adam and Wea. Strike one called. Got the outside corner. And the next one will hit him. Looked like a breaking ball that didn't break. And there are now two men aboard. Cody Schaefer is the batter. Delivers one that goes outside. And the next one will be low, blocked by Fenner. Two balls, no strikes. Swing, and this one is deep. Back goes Barwick. He's not going to be able to get to that one. It bounces to the wall. One run is in, and now maybe another. There will be no play as it is held by Amundson at short after the cut. A two RBI double here in the first off the bat of Cody Schaefer. Kyle Mrozinski is the batter, and it's a 0-1 count to him. Swing, that sounded like a broken bat. Roll it or short, the throw is made for out number two. Cole Hansen steps in for the Storm. He is their first baseman. bats left. It's 0-1 to him. Wallace sends one wide, evens the count. It is 1-1. Wallace sets, checks the runner, and delivers. Breaking ball doesn't quite find the zone. Look good, but it's 2-1. Next one outside. 3-1 now. Swing and a miss. Fills the count. Swing and a miss. He got him. The Storm are retired in the first. They put up 2 runs, and the A's find themselves in an early hole coming up to bat in the first. This is A's Baseball, brought to you by Trilling True Value Hardware. Bottom of inning number 1, and the leadoff batter will be Dan Barwick. Represents the first A's batter of the game. To Barwick. Starting on the mound for the Storm is Brett Knorr. Knorr winds and delivers. A hopper. Knorr jumps for it, can't get to it, and it'll be through the middle for a single. Up will come Blake Fleischman. Mm-hmm. Brett Norr does his college playing at St. Norbert's, and now one goes through the right side off the bat of Fleischman. A single, and two men aboard for the A's in the early going. And in will step Wyatt Olson. Olson swings at the first one, and it's a line drive. They will double up Barwick. Not much he could do about that one. It was right at him, and even with his lead, he probably would have been out. So a quick double play, and Harry Stelt will be the batter for the A's. Two-way runner aboard first. And ball one to Harry Stelt. Green Bay tagged starter Mark Wallace for two in the top half. He's had a good chance to answer back. Fleischman goes now, and he'll be in. The throw was off. Had a chance to get him in a rundown, but he'll get the stolen base. Throw from Green Bay first baseman Hansen was high. Now he is with a man in scoring position. Strike one called. That one got past the catcher and through his legs. Fleischman will stay at second. Three and one to Harry Stelt. Or checks Fleischman a couple of times, delivers one that's outside. It'll be ball four. In the latter half of the season, Stelt has been much more judicious about his pitch selection, and it has paid off in spades. He's gotten on base much, much more, and his batting average has gone up, struggled early on. He's been much better down the stretch. And here's Taylor Grimm. Take strike one. That one got the outside corner. Grimm did the catching this past weekend. Now is in the lineup as the designated hitter. Swing, that one will be a grounder through the left side. Loomins is waving Fleischman home. He'll be in with no play for the first run of the game for the A's. RBI single for Taylor Grimm, and Adam Ryan will step in. will take strike one. And then ball one. That one inside. And that one almost got him. They'll say it did. It brushed him, and he'll get first base. So how about it? Bases are loaded for Cutter Amundson. Here in the first inning, both starters have hit a man. Amundson coming off a hot game last night. He had four hits, powering the A's offense that put up 14 runs on Manitowoc. And here's one for tonight. That one into the gap in left. One run will be in. Two runs will be in. And here comes the third. The throw is high. And Amundson on the high throw will go from second to third. And just like that, the A's have doubled up the Green Bay Storm. So Amundson on third, taking everyone off the bases but himself. It is 4-2 in the A's favor. They're still in the bat. Here is the catcher, Hayden Fenner. Fenner swings and misses. Swings at the next one. Will it get down? It does not. It is caught. It didn't fade quite enough. Caught out and left by Mitch Egan, and the A's go down. But they have the lead, 4-2 after one complete. This is A's Baseball, brought to you by Meesfeld's, makers of quality meats since 1941. Bob Lemieux, leadoff batter in the second for the Green Bay Storm. Hey, Lemieux, that is a name that you might know if you're a hockey fan. Mario Lemieux, one of the hockey greats. Had a long, great career for the Penguins, Mario Lemieux, and now he's one of the owners. I'm afraid that's about all I can tell you about him. Only a casual hockey fan. As it pertains to baseball, I read an article in Sports Illustrated that when they had the World Baseball Classic, the effect of hockey is so pervasive in Canada that 8 out of 9 Canadian batters batted left-handed. Now Lemieux will go down on strikes, 4 out number 1. Here is the pitcher, Brett Knorr. Swing and a foul in the backstop makes it 1 ball and 1 strike to Knorr. Ball 2. Swing and a pop up out of play. It's 2 balls and 2 strikes to Knorr. And he will look at ball 3, that one low and away, full count. Into the windup, and here's the payoff pitch, just got a piece of it. Here's the next one, breaking ball that is too high. Knorr will get first base. And Cato Kasberg is the batter for the Green Bay Storm. Right fielder number 9, Cato Kasberg. Squares to bunt, he gets it down, is fielded by Wallace, he bobbles it, as the grass out there still wet, and couldn't get a grip on the ball, so Kasberg will be on first, runners on first and second, and back to the top of the order for the Green Bay Storm. Mitch Egan is the batter. He squares to bunt, and Wallace gets a hold of this one and flips it underhand, 4 out number 2. Tyler Brown. He is the center fielder. Singled his first time up and then was driven in by Cody Schaefer. Oh, and one after a foul ball. swing this one into shallow right. It will be caught by Olsen. Four out number three. The Storm leave two men stranded, fail to put up a run. The A's will have an opportunity in the bottom half. This is Sheboygan A's Baseball, brought to you by Q-Mart. Cole McLavick is the leadoff man for the A's. It is the bottom of inning number two. Swing, and this one way up there. Comes right to center fielder Tyler Brown, four out number one.
Center fielder Dan Barber.
Dan Barwick in. Sends a bouncer that goes foul past third. One and one to Barwick. And the next one low and away. Pop up in the infield. This one will be caught by Adam and we are at short.
Second baseman, Blake Fleischman.
And here is Blake Fleischman. Ball one to Fleischman, that was inside. Swing at the next one, this one into left field, and it is caught for out number three. Three fly balls in a row, three up, three down for the A's. After two complete, it is the Sheboygan A's 4, Green Bay Storm 2. This is Sheboygan Baseball, brought to you by Trilling True Value Hardware. Adam Anwia, Cody Schaefer, and Kyle Mrazinski will be the batters for the Storm in the third. Hello, everyone. For those of you just joining us, I'm Jared Ertman alongside Carson Oosterman to bring you Sheboygan A's baseball tonight, taking on the Green Bay Storm in a game in the Northeastern Wisconsin League. Again, in the Northeastern Wisconsin League, top four teams, all with four losses. The Macs stand atop the standings. They played the most games. They are 10-4, so have the best winning percentage. The Legends of Appleton and the A's, both with 9-4. And this one could be, and it is, a solo home run for Adam Anwia. A shot that goes about 325 in the left. Wallace put it just a bit too far over the plate, and he gave it a ride. So no men on, no outs yet, and Wea with the leadoff home run, and here is Cody Schaefer. He's the second baseman for the Storm. Swings and misses. No balls, two strikes. Swing and a miss. He got him. One away for Kyle Mrazinski. Wallace's first pitch to Mrazinski just misses outside. Swing, bounce it a short, handled by Amundsen, and the throw made. This is Cole Hansen. And Wallace sends him a breaking ball that misses low and away. Next one is inside for ball two. Swings at the next one. This one foul and looks like it'll get out of play. It does. Behind third base. Stelton Amundsen going after it. Swing, sharp one to first, and it will be taken unassisted by Adam Ryan, four out number three. Solo homer in the leadoff spot by Adam Anwia, but the Storm get no more offense in the inning. A's retain a one-run lead coming up into the bottom half. Wyatt Olson is the leadoff man. He'll be followed by Harry Stelt and Taylor Grimm. What an old Olson. More winds and delivers. Swing, chopper, that is. Stopped at third, and the throw is there. And up will come Harry Stelt. Stelt watches ball one. And the next one zooms inside. Next one is low in the zone, a good pitch for strike one. And the next one will be outside for ball three. Swing and a foul away, that will fill the count. Ball four, and Stelt will draw his second walk of the game. High fly ball, it's in the infield, and it will be caught by Anwia. That's out number two. First baseman Adam Ryan in now for the A's. Swing, and this one deep into right. It will hit the wall at the Bud Light sign right underneath the scoreboard, and it'll be a stand-up double. Stelt will hold at third. So a nice shot by Ryan, and there are two men in scoring position for Carter Amundson. Swing, this one a hot one to short. Amundson hustling it out, and he is safe. An infield single for Amundson, and an RBI as well. That makes it the Green Bay Storm 3, or Sheboygan A's 5. And we'll bring up Hayden Fenner with runners on the corners. Amundsen goes, and he gets caught in a rundown and will get tagged out. But the A's played a run as Adam Ryan makes it across at the end of three complete. It is the A's 6, the Green Bay Storm 3. This is A's Baseball, brought to you by Bank First National.
And Bob Lemieux leads off Green Bay as we go into the top of the fourth. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Carson Osman. I'll bring you the next few innings of A's baseball. A's have a current lead 6-3 over Green Bay. And 1-0 count. And there's another ball outside. Mark Wallace on the mound tonight, and there's a strike for third pitch, 2-1 count now. And there's ball number 3. A little cloudy out here in over at Wildwood Baseball Park tonight, and he's going to hook that one into left field, and it's going to be foul. Full count now. Full count pitch, and that one's going to be hit straight up. And looks like Adam Ryan's going to grab that one. Out number 1. And no one on bases yet. And here comes pitcher Brett Knorr. Ball inside for the first pitch. And there's a ball outside. 3-0 count now on Nor. And there's ball four for the walk, putting a runner on first now for Green Bay. Cato Casper at the plate now. Oh, and one count. And he puts out the bunt. And Wallace and Fenner's gonna grab that. Wallace misled Fenner. Is in another run for Green Bay. A little bit of a miscommunication there. And Green Bay has come in with four runs now. 6-4. A's are still leading. Mitch Egan at the plate now. There's strike number one, 1-1 count now. With one out and just a runner on second. And another ball outside. There's a swing and a miss for strike number two. 2-2 count now. And there's strike number three. Goes down looking. There's two outs now. Tyler Brown coming up now. Ball high for the first throw. And there's a swing for strike one. All low and outside. Two on count now on Brown. And that one's going to be hit way out there. Way foul. 2-2 now. And ball outside. Runner will stay at second. Full count now. And there's another one hit way up there. And looks like Adam Ryan's going to grab this one too. And there's three. And we'll go into the bottom of the fourth inning with A's leading 6-4. And here comes Hayden Fenner leading off the A's in the bottom of the fourth inning. And he puts out the bunt, but it's going to be way inside, and he's going to have to pull that one back in. Fenner hits one into center field, caught for out number one.
Left fielder, number four.
And here's Cole McLavick coming up now. Ball high for the first pitch. And there's strike number one. And ball just outside. There's one inside now. 3-1 count. And there's ball number four, sending McLavick to first. Here comes Dan Barwick pulling the center field position this game. And McLavick's going to steal second, be safe on the slide. Thank you. is a high ball. Count on Barwick now. And there's strike number one. Barwick's going to hit a hopper, and it's going to go right over the pitcher. And grabbed by short, thrown to first for out number two. McGlavick going back to second, remains safe. And here's Blake Fleischman. Fleischman hits that one foul down the first baseline. And there's a little hopper to second, and going to be thrown first for out number three. Scoreless inning for the A's, coming in to the top of the fifth with a score of 6-4. A's still hanging on to the lead. And here comes shortstop number 21, Adam Anguillo, leading off Green Bay in the top of the fifth inning. Ball low and outside for first pitch. There's strike number one. Two-one count now on Adam Anguillo. And there's ball number three. Man, that one's going to be way up there. And it'll be caught for out number one.
Second baseman, Cody.
And here's Cody Schaefer. There's strike one on the first pitch. And that one's going to be right down the third base line past Stelt, and it's going to get all the way into left field. But they're going to get hold the runner at first. Kyle Merzinski, number six, playing third base tonight. And another one hit way up there. It's going to be foul ball. One count now, and there's a ball in the dirt, and runner will advance to second. Another one down third baseline, going to be grabbed by Stelt and thrown to first. Just in the nick of time for the out, and there's out number two.
First baseman, Cole Hansen.
And here's first baseman Cole Hansen now. There's a swing for strike three, and Fenner's going to gun it over. It's going to be over Stelt's head, and it's going to bring in another run for Green Bay. Six-five, Sheboygan A's now, and Green Bay has empty bases. And 2-1 count now. And that one's gonna be hit right over Fleischman into center right field. Right center field. And here's the catcher, Bob Lemieux. And there's strike one on the first pitch. And strike number two. runner will take second base. One and two count now. That one's way up there. And Adam Ryan with another pop fly catch for another final out. And we go into the bottom of the fifth with the score 6-5, Sheboygan A's. And here comes Wyatt Olson leading off the A's in the bottom of the fifth. There's one right past third base in the left field, and Wyatt Olson will get on base. And here comes Harry Stelt up to the plate now. Pitcher tries to throw out Olson at first, but will be unsuccessful. And there's the ball outside. Stelt hits that one into the first base side net. 1-1 count now. Pitch, and it's going to be a hopper right to, going to bounce right off second baseman, and Wyatt Olson's going to go to third. Mm. Allen took a nasty hop off the second baseman and rolled right into right center field. Wyatt Olson gaining two bases on that, and Harry Stelt getting on first. And here's Taylor Grimm batting now. And there's strike number one. And Wyatt Olson's going to come in. And he's going to be called out. And there's out number one. Grimm's going to hook down into foul territory on the third base side. One, two count on Taylor Grimm now. And there's a hit right between first and second into right field. And Stelt's going to get to third, round it, but not go. And here comes Adam Ryan up to the plate.
First baseman, number 39, Adam Ryan.
There's a ball way inside. And there's strike number one. One count on Adam Ryan. And there's a swing for strike number two. Ryan's going to hit that one right through the legs of the first baseman, bringing in Harry Stelt for another run. And putting Taylor Grimm at third. And here is Carter Amundson now. And there's strike one. Amundsen's going to get that one right to short. And Adam Ryan's going to be tagged out. Looked like he was trying to get to the third there, but Taylor Grimm wasn't moving. Here's Hayden Fenner up to bat now. And strike number one. Amundsen is going to steal second. To the pitcher and dropped and scooped and tossed to first for out number three. Hayes bring in one run for 7-5 lead now as we go into the top of the sixth inning. Here's Brett Knorr leading off Green Bay in the top of the sixth inning. And a ball low and outside from Wallace to start off this inning. And there's a swing for strike one. Two and one count now. And that one's gonna be hit way up there. That one's gonna be in the stands. Two and two count. And there's a ball high for a full count now. There's a strikeout for out number one as in the sixth inning. And here's Keto Kasberg. Foul ball behind the plate. There's the ball right down first baseline, and it's going to be grabbed by Adam Ryan for another out, two outs. And here's Mitch Egan now. There's going to be a swing right over Wallace's head to Fleischman, and he's going to be just a bit late on the throw. Took a little bit too much time, and he'll be safe. Tyler Brown. Hit to short and run over and tap on second for out number three, and going to the bottom of the sixth inning with a score still remaining 7-5, Sheboygan A's.
the half inning for Sheboygan. Cole McLovin.
And Austin Dessine comes in to pitch for Green Bay as we go into the bottom of the sixth inning. And Cole McLavick leads us off. Ball high, 1-1 count on McLavick now. And there's another ball. One's outside. 2-2 now. Glavik hooks that one way into the outfield, and it will not be caught, and he's going to go to second, and he'll put on the brakes there.
Center fielder number 4, Dan Barwick.
And here comes Dan Barwick batting now. Strike number 1. And there's strike 2. 0-2 count on Barwick now. And foul ball over the first base side. Another one into the backstop. And ball high. Foul ball by Barwick, 2-2 count. Ball 4. And here comes number 35, Blake Fleischman. Fleischman. ball low. Fleischman hits that one over to the third base side. One count on Blake Fleischman now. And there's another foul ball. Pitch is going to be hit right past pitcher and past second base into center field, and Cole McGlavick comes in for the run. 8-5 now, Sheboygan A's. Barwick on second and Fleischman on first now as Wyatt Olson comes up to the plate. We'll see if he can bring in a couple more runs. First pitch to Wyatt Olson, gonna be a ball high. And foul ball into the backstop. Ball outside, 2-1 count on Olson now. And another foul ball from Olson, bringing it to 2-2 count now. There's a dribbler to second, and we throw him first for first out. And here's Harry Stelt coming up now. Looks like they're pitching out for Stelt. Stealth on the bases. And after the pitch out for Harry Stell, Taylor Grimm is going to come up to the plate. Pitch to Taylor Grimm is going to be gone out of here for a grand slam.
Did I not just call that? Did
And bringing in 4 runs, 12-5 score now.
Wow. You can call him magical. First baseman, number 39, Adam Lyon.
Here's Adam Ryan. One and all count. And there's a swing for first strike. 1-1 count on Adam Ryan now. 2-1. And there's another swing and a miss by Adam Ryan. 2-2 now. Full count on Adam Ryan now. And they're going to walk him. Another pitching change. And looks like Green Bay is going to have a pitching change. And here's Carter Amundson. And Green Bay with their pitching change to Alex Wendricks now. Edmondson with a 1-0 count. And there's the first strike. And there's a swing and a miss for strike number two. Edmondson is going to hit that one way up, and it's going to be right against the fence and caught. Two outs now for the A's. Hayden Fenner coming up to bat now. And Hayden Fenner's going to be hit and send first. Klavik now with a 0-1 count, coming up to the plate with two outs for the A's, and he's going to hit that one right over shortstop, and it's going to bring in Adam Ryan and put Hayden Fenner at second and himself at first. And 2-0 count on Dan Barwick. One count now. And a hopper to third baseman going to be grabbed and tagged up for out number three. A's go into the top of the seventh inning with a 13-5 lead. First pitch from Wallace is going to be hit way up there by Anwea. And going to be caught by Amundson at short. Two and two count now. And there's a foul ball. There's a hit, and they get right past Stelp. And Green Bay gets a runner on first, and here comes Kyle Merzinski to bat now. Pop to left center, and then be grabbed by Barwick.
First baseman number 20, Cole Hansen.
And that one's going to get right past Fleischman, and now two runners on base for Green Bay. Catcher Bob Lemieux batting for Green Bay now. Base is loaded with two outs now. And A's put AJ Alessi on the mound now. Here's a pinch hitter, Mike Nitti, coming in for Green Bay now. And ball low for first pitch. He's heading. He's going to be thrown to first just in time for the out. A's go into the bottom of the seventh inning with a 13-5 lead, two runs to win the game.
Off the bottom is 7 3 years.
And here's Blake Fleischman leading off the Sheboygan A's in the bottom of the seventh inning. There's a ball for the first pitch, and here's pitch number two. It's going to be foul ball down the third base side. One count on Fleischman now. And Fleischman will be safe, and first baseman stepped off the base and missed the tag. Here's Wyatt Olson. And pitcher looks to get Fleischman at first, but no chance. There's strike number one on Wyatt Olson. And ball outside, 1-1 count now. And foul ball, 1-2 count now. Ball outside, and Fleischman's going to take second. Full count on Wyatt Olson now. And there's ball four, and he's going to go to first. Here's Harry Stout. Holds back that swing and still gets strike one. And ball outside, 1-1 count for Harry Stout now. Here comes the 1-1 pitch. Gonna be a ball high, 2-1 now. And there is strike number two. That's going to be not a great... fans won't really like that call. Two now for Harry Stelt. And a ball high, full count now. And a swing and a miss for strike number three. One out as Taylor Grimm comes up to the plate. Grimm's going to hit that one right to the third baseman for first out. And there's a second out. And we're going to go into inning number eight. 13-5 lead yet.
Number nine batter. I don't write numbers down generally. Cato. Cato Casper.
Into the eighth we go, and the batter for the Green Bay Storm will be Cato Casberg. Hello, everyone. I am Jared Ertman here to bring you the last couple of innings. Your Sheboygan A's are up 13-5 on the visiting Green Bay Storm, due in large part to a grand slam off the bat of Taylor Grimm back in the sixth. Pitching on the mound, A.J. Alessi. He came in relief of Mark Wallace. Past inning, you get the final out. Now a grounder to second for a routine first out. Top of the order for Green Bay. That means Mitch Egan is in. Green Bay's mustered a decent amount of offense in the game. They did have a solo home run from Adam Enwea leading off in the third. Nine hits. A's have just outdone them tonight at the plate. 13 runs on 13 hits. Swing and a foul away on the 0-2. Swing and a sharp one to short. Amundson has it and makes the throw.
Just clip off.
Two up, two down, and Tyler Brown is the batter.
Next up for the Storm, the center fielder, number 7, Tyler Brown.
Yes. I made up this little cheat sheet of basic facts and whatnot.
Swing, this one to third. Stelt has it, bobbles it, and that'll be another error in the game for Harry Stelt. Runner aboard for the Green Bay Storm. And here is Adam Enwea. And Wea, 1-for-3 tonight with a couple of runs scored. He was hit by a pitch in the first in addition to his solo homer. Watches ball one. He's poised here to go 10-4 in the Wisconsin State League, and again the top four, rather the Northeastern Wisconsin League, and in the Northeastern Wisconsin League, top four teams all have four losses. Fall back and out of play. Makes it 2-1 to Adam Enwea. The Northeastern Wisconsin Baseball League is a top-tier wooden bat adult semi-professional baseball league located in northeastern Wisconsin. Players in the league are considered amateur status and are not paid, and consist mostly of former and current college ball players as well as many former professional players. Again, the A's play in both the Northeastern Wisconsin League and the Wisconsin State League. Strike called, and Wea wanted ball four. But that fills the count. Alessi looks in, sets and delivers the payoff. That one was just a little inside, and then Wea will get his base. Here is Cody Schaefer, who's also contributed to the Green Bay offense tonight. He is 3-for-4 thus far. Has 2 RBI and a run scored. Swing, and this one into center. And it will be caught by McLavick for out number 3.
We had a change. I think Barwick's out.
Adam Ryan will lead off for the A's in the eighth. Pitching change for the Green Bay Storm. To the mound now is Kirio Kasper. Swing and a foul into the backstop. Ball one. Evens the count to Ryan. A's needing just a few more runs here to put away the Green Bay Storm. Of course, they'll need just three outs in the top of the ninth otherwise. Two balls and one strike. Katzberg winds and delivers. That one is ball three. And then ball four. Here is Carter Amundson. Amundson 2-for-4 tonight. With 4 RBI. Also stole a base. It's 0-1 to him now. And then ball one. Amundson sends one back to the mound. They get the lead runner. And the next, a 1-6-3 double play. Oh. Two-way. And Hayden Fenner to the plate. Oh, for 3 tonight. Reached in the sixth when he was hit by a pitch. He'll swing and miss, takes the big cut, doesn't quite make contact. And ball one, that was low. Into the windup, and here's the next offering. It's fouled away. Old Fenner awaiting the 1-2. Time is called. Katzberg took his time and delivering that pitch. Time back in. And here he comes with it. Swung on and missed. The A's are down in the eighth. Three up, three down. But they'll need just three more outs. For Green Bay, they'll need those three to make up 8 runs. This is Sheboygan A's Baseball, brought to you by Faze Pizza. Thank you.
runs to second.
Into the ninth, and the last three batters potentially for Green Bay, Kyle Mozinski, Cole Hansen, Bob Lemieux, they'll look to keep things going. They will need eight runs to do so. A few changes in the field for the A's. Now a ball in the right field. It'll be caught by Olsen for out number one. Last inning, Weston Nelson went into left, and Cole McLavick went into center. Dan Bowie came out, and now Ben Gordon at second here in the top of the ninth, replacing Blake Fleischman. Cole Hansen is the batter for Green Bay, and Alessi sets and delivers. Swing, another fly ball, this one into shallow left. Nelson will have it for the second out. And now Bob Lemieux steps in as Green Bay's last chance. Ball one. Unless he sends one in, and this one will be caught by Nelson. A four-pitch ninth inning, and that is the ball game.
Line score for tonight's game for Green Bay, 5 runs, 9 hits, and 2 errors.
Time of the game, 2 hours and 28 minutes. Line the score, Green Bay, 5 runs on 9 hits, 2 errors. Sheboygan, 13 runs on 13 hits and 4 errors. Oh, A's win this one going away, and they have 3 multiple run innings, 4 in the first to go up after Green Bay scored a couple in the top half, then 2 in the third, and then they busted things wide open in the sixth. That was a 6-run inning, and 4 of those runs were driven in by Taylor Grimm, a grand slam, and boy, that one was out of here. A's improve their record on the season to 24-13 and 10-4 in the Northeastern Wisconsin League, move into a tie for first with Menasha. Winning on the mound for the A's tonight is Mark Wallace in 6.7 innings pitched. A.J. Alessi with the hold. Losing pitcher for the visiting Green Bay Storm will be Brett Knorr, the starter, who went 5 innings. And offensive performances tonight. Of course, there was the grand slam by Grimm. Grimm going 3-for-5, also had a couple of singles. 5 RBIs overall and 2 runs scored as well for Grimm. Adam Ryan scored 3 runs and went 1-for-2, drew a couple of walks, and was hit by a pitch. Connor Amundsen continues with his hot bat. He had 4 RBI and went 2-for-3, also stole a base. Cole McLavick also contributed tonight, going 2-for-3, also with a walk, a stolen base, and a run scored. For the visiting Green Bay Storm, Adam and Wea going 1-for-3. That one was a solo homer in the third, scored a couple of runs. The other one besides his home run was result of getting on base in the first after being hit by a pitch. He drew a walk in the eighth. And Cole Hansen, only other Green Bay Storm member of note, multiple hits, going 2-for-5 tonight, also with a stolen base. So again, the A's improved their record to 24-13 on the season, 10-4 in the Northeastern Wisconsin League. Their next couple of games will be non-league games. They'll host the Chicago Clout in a doubleheader this weekend. That will be Strikeout Cancer Day this coming Saturday. They'll then resume league play Monday at Menasha in a battle of league leaders. So the A's get back on a winning track here at Wildwood Park, and they'll be home this weekend to continue the win streak. That's what they'll look to do. I'm Jared Ertman for Carson Oosterman. Have a good night, everyone.